How does it do that?
Through a cycle of evaporation inside and condensation outside.
Tara? I think I might be kind of stuck.
Fantastic! That means you've reached the expansion valve. You're about to re-enter the refrigerome and experience evaporation firsthand.
I don't think I like evaporation! Oh, where am I now? And where did all the refrigerant go?
Oh, it's still there, Bing. It just turned from a liquid into a gas. That's evaporation.
What does evaporation have to do with making the refrigerant cold?
Well, when the liquid refrigerant turns into a gas, it captures heat from the air around it.
Yeah, it is getting kind of warm in here. And windy.
Hang on, Ben. You're about to be pushed to the outside coil again.
Refrigerant has turned back into a liquid.
Exactly. When a gas turns into a liquid, that's called condensation. Condensation releases heat.
Huh. So evaporation on the inside coil captures heat?
Uh-huh.
And condensation on the outside coil releases it?
You got it.
Wait. So refrigerants don't add cold air inside? They just take heat away?
Bing! Evaporation and condensation! Capturing and releasing heat! Over and over and over and over and over again!
Whoa! That's awesome!
Yeah, sure is! And now, you have everything you need to deliver your answer!
Not exactly, Tara.
What are you talking about? What else could you possibly need to know?
How do I get out of here?
A refrigerator's got a big job to do. It's gotta chill those foods and drinks for you. And the way it works is cool as can be. A fluid called refrigerant is the key. When it's pumped inside that